A few weeks ago, I made a video on the previous version of Stable Video Infinity Laura. A second version of the same has been released, and it looks interesting and works with the WAN 2.2 model as well. This 3-minute video looks like it was generated from the latest version. I don't remember this video when I visited this page a few weeks ago. Let's check how it works. This is a short workflow for testing. And it worked. Not perfectly, but that is due to the prompt. Let's look at the files used. These are the Lightning LoRa for both high and low noise models. And then the Stable Video Infinity files used as a LoRa, both high and low noise LoRa, goes to the respective high and low noise GGUF model. Here I am using the Q6 GGUF model, which should work on a 12GB card. Below is the VAE and the FP8 text encoder, and that's all in this section. Block swap node for low VRAM cases, it makes a significant difference, hence connected with both the models. This is the first 5 seconds of the video, and this is the continued video after the first 5 seconds. So this can be said as the main workflow, where I have uploaded the image, and the second group of nodes is to continue the video. This group of nodes can be added further to generate the next 80 frames and continue the video. The output from the first node group is taken as a reference to maintain the consistency in the second node group for generating the video. Right now I am working with a short 10-second video and trying different LoRa for acceleration. So, I have uploaded an image of the woman walking, and the prompt for this image was given by GPT. The image was generated using the Z-image model. Below are the actions which can be done by the woman in the image. So, I will paste the prompt and the second prompt in the other text encode node. I will bypass this and try for the first 5 seconds. The seed ID in the main workflow is fixed, so I can continue the video generation after the first 80 frames. The resolution you see here is small, but finding the best settings in LoRa files are practical at smaller resolutions after multiple tests. Once you get the best settings, you can increase the resolution to generate better quality output. This one step takes around 20 seconds with a Q6 GGUF model. But the RAM consumption looks high. Still, this should work on a 32GB system. The video generation took 145 seconds, and the result looks fine. I will activate the remaining nodes and run the workflow. As said before, the generation starts from here, because the previous K-sampler gave the same result due to the fixed seed ID. The next 80 frames take the same time as it was for the first 80 frames. And the result was generated after 147 seconds, which is a 10-second video. I will copy this node group and paste it here. Make this connection, which brings the output from the left as a reference to the right, for generating the next 80 frames. I will copy the third prompt and paste it here, and click the Run button to cue the workflow. Because the seed ID and other values in the previous node group are unchanged, the output is given without processing, which brings the video generation directly to the third node group. The time taken to process one step is just above 20 seconds, and after 152 seconds, I got the result, which made this a 15-second clip. The video generated looks fine to me, but the prompt given by GPT does not go with the image. I copied the node group again for the next 81 frames. The prompt given here says about, a cyclist passes by. I am sure this is not possible in the current scene. The image prompt given by GPT should also have included people and cyclists to make this happen. It took 160 seconds, and then the fourth part of the video has been appended after the previous 15 seconds. And the cyclist did not appear, but the video did not break. The character still has the natural movements. I am using the 5.1 model here, and it works sometimes, but not all the time. I will try once again with this traveler exploring ancient ruins. I got the image to start with, and you need to check this prompt and make changes to make it work with your image. It should work on a simple video where the person is standing in front of the camera, posing or dancing. But making someone exploring needs proper ending frames, or at least the prompt should be based on the last scene created. I have uploaded the image and will generate the first 80 frames with the first prompt where the traveler is walking into ruins. This is the first 80 frames. Now trying the second 80 frames for a 10-second video. After 160 seconds, this is the result. In a similar way, I continued and used all the prompts, so I will not be explaining the same thing again. This is the 20-second clip in length. The seed IDs in each generation are different. Just keep a note of it before copying and pasting. I have added the link to the files, and this is the video link you are watching. Next is the link to the FP8 models, and I will be downloading this model, the E4 version of both high and low noise models. Then there are the GGUF models, high and low noise both. You can have a model around the same size of your card. The block swap node should make it work, but you should have the system RAM so the block swap works. These are the direct link to the Q6 model I was using just now. Next is the GGUF text encoders, which should work on systems with smaller cards. But I suggest trying the FP8 encoder first. I am using the same, and it should work on an 8GB card. This is the direct link to the VE, and these are for the Lightning LoRa, both high and low noise models. Below is the simple upscaler. If you saw the previous video, I will be using the same upscaler to make the video look better. I will update the workflow for upscaler later. Right now, I have missed adding this Stable Video Infinity LoRa. The SVI LoRa Direct download link was added, so that's all needed for this workflow. The workflow you see here is for the GGUF models. Running FP8 needs few changes. I made a duplicate workflow and just made a few changes to make it work. The difference is not much after deleting this. I tried generating the first 80 frames, and the system usage looks similar when I was using the GGUF models. The generation time taken was around 200 seconds instead of 160 seconds. The result looks fine. I need to increase the resolution to see a noticeable difference. I made this 50-second video. The project works, but you need to write your prompts based on the previous scene. The GPT 5.1 model I was using did not work for me. Maintaining standing characters should be easy, and the quality can be increased up to 720 pixels. I think I should be making a video on upscaling results because now generating a 50-second video is possible even on smaller cards with a decent consistency. The workflow became lengthy though. Let me know if you have any thoughts on this. I would like to see your results. Have a great day ahead.